day, friends. It is me, HLModTech, and I am back with another fun, fast Tinkercad tutorial. So let's get cracking. Today, friends, we are going to make a box with lid, and this is another request from Brian, who's one of my favorite viewers. Friends, we're going to start by once again bringing out that soft box. It is just so slick for this type of project. Now, I'm going to choose to make mine 60 by 80, so it's a reasonable size. I'm going to make my walls 3. And since I don't have a real use for this, I'm just gonna stay with those measurements. This'll print reasonably fast and it'll be easy for us to test. Now we need a back for this design. Watch this. If we do Control D and we type and we put a number like 30 in the middle, bingo, it becomes solid. I'm gonna just change Z to 1 because that's how thick I wanna make that. And then we can select the two of them, press L for align, and we're gonna click center and center. Don't forget, if you look from this corner, it makes it more clear why that's the center. That, my friends, is the bottom of our box. Control G and group it. Now Brian requested that it have a sliding lid, so let me show you how we're gonna make that. Let's take our current piece and do Control D, and let's ungroup it, and then we'll move this to the side, and we're gonna use this one to cut out where the sliding part goes. So I want you to change the Z to 2.5. This will be reasonably thick, and we're gonna make it a hole, and we're gonna subtract some of these numbers. So instead of 60, let's do 56. So we're leaving 4. And then for Z, instead of 80, let's just do 78. If we select these two, press L for align, click on our shape, and choose center. Once again, I'm gonna look at it from the corner, and I'm gonna go to this corner, and I also wanna move it to the top. Now we are gonna sink it down by doing Control down arrow, and I'm gonna go down 2 millimeters. Now with it totally lined up that way, we need to make it poke out the back. So I'm gonna take this Y, and I'm actually gonna make it 82. Notice it moved that way. So now I'm gonna use my arrow keys to pull it back till I see it touch that edge. So see how it came out? Now I can push it in, and I'm going to leave just a little bit of it inside there so this can completely close, but you can see out here, but you can see it actually comes all the way out here, so it cuts. Friends, we're going to reuse that. Do Control D, do D to drop, and let's do Shift Nudge to move it to the other side. Let's take these two pieces, and let's do Control G to group. After a moment, you have got the area for the lid. Now I want to make this lid so it slides reasonably easy. I'm also going to make it so it does not pop out. So first things, let's do 79. That should make it so it fits perfect. I'm going to change the color. We'll test this in a minute. Let's go with a blue. And then I'm going to change Z from 2.5 to 2. So it should have enough friction to hold it in place. I'm going to also change X to 55 to give it a little bit of leeway as well. Let's do W for work plane, click up on the lip, press D for drop, press L for align. I'm going to make this one the master. Let's slide it all the way out to that edge, and let's make sure it's in the middle, which it is. That looks pretty groovy. If we nudge this back, let's see how far it's going to push in. So it would probably go to right there, and then it would stick out too far. So I'm going to change this Y to 78. And that way it'll be underneath the cover. That, I think, is going to be fantastic. You can see it does actually close. Now we need a way to open it. I'm going to set the work plane on top of the blue piece, bring out the round roof. I'm going to get it so it's aligned. So shift select, choose align, and I want it center. And then I'm going to simply make it a hole, and I'm going to do control down so it sinks in 1 millimeter. If I select those two and I group them, you will see now there is a little rectangle that'll let us slide it open or closed. I'm gonna put the work plane on the ground so you can see it better. And friends, there you have it. We have got our design. I'm gonna delete this one. I'm gonna take the blue one. I'm gonna do shift nudge to get it to the other side. Let's do D to drop, and we'll send it to the 3D printer and see just how this turns out. Exporting in Tinkercad is simple. I'm going to click on each piece because I'm going to take it to two different printers. We simply choose export, and this time we're only doing the selected shape, STL. I'm going to save this as lid. I'm going to replace the one that was there and hit save. Now click on the second part, export as well. Once again, it's going to be an STL and only the selected shape. Call it box with lid, and bingo, I can send it to two different 3D printers and see what we get. The lid was under 30 minutes on the GE Tech A10T. This is the box on the ANET A8 Plus, and as you can see, it's got one little bobble where it goes across that corner, but it did a fantastic job spanning that lip on the front. I did speed this up so you'll be able to see it tested in just a moment. All right, everybody, so it is the moment of truth. Let's pull it off. And slide it in. Oh my gosh, friends, how cool is that? Once again, huge shout out to Brian for asking the question. Friends, as I wrap up, let me remind you about my website, hlmodtech.com. I've got the page dedicated to Tinkercad with a ton of awesome categories, and then right below it, the first day lessons. These are great for anybody that's just starting out in Tinkercad. Friends, I also want to highlight the super cool built-in messaging. You can click that button, add your question, comment, or suggestion, and reach me almost instantly. Friends, I do also want to highlight the link to the Tinkercad community Discord. As you can see, there are more than 600 members, and it's a fantastic place to talk everything Tinkercad. Finally, friends, of course, if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. Please also hit that share button so more people can learn about HL Mod Tech. Of course, friends, you absolutely make my day if you take time to leave a comment down below. And if you haven't subscribed yet, what are you waiting for? Smash that subscribe button, and last but not least, hit that notification bell if you want to be the first to know when there's a brand new video from me, HL Mod Tech. Thanks for watching. Have a great day.